Can we do the minutes first?
I can give that to you.
Okay, we have the minutes from last week's meeting. Any... Any discussion?
Just one quick note, it's just... On Article 6, down bottom, first page, Police Department, just a typo, salary shortfall.
Good catch.
Salary?
Allery?
Could be Allery.
Salary, yeah, salary.
It's my big fingers typing a little keyboard.
Okay. Anything else?
Thank you.
This is an extra copy of the motions.
If there are no other changes or...
I haven't seen any. I have a motion to accept the minutes.
It's a motion to accept the minutes as corrected. Second, all those in favor?
Excellent minutes.
Yeah, very good minutes.
Five.
Five, yep.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five.
Yeah. John and Mary are here, obviously.
Oh, John is not coming tonight?
No.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay. So there was, there would have been room for me over there?
Yeah, there is.
That's good. Okay, slide that way. So I have room at the table?
It's the 18th, I thought it was the 17th.
Yeah, 18th today.
Because I was planning to be here on the 17th.
So, town office maintenance budget?
For your suggestion, the select board did vote to put in $25,000 for the church building.
Do they define the maintenance?
Well, heat, not water, that kind of stuff.
Okay.
Heat, not water, and that kind of stuff.
I don't like that kind of stuff.
Maintaining to protect and preserve the building.
It's essentially the budget that the church has this year was, I think, $15,000 for heat, and which they haven't spent, but who knows?
Yep.
And I think $3,000 or $4,000 for electricity. So, you know, $25,000 was just a number. Any questions?
Okay, I'll move to accept the town office building management budget of $418,17.
Maintenance.
Maintenance, right.
$418,17.
April 18th today.
Oh.
As opposed to $360,000.
$90,400.
But it increased by...
$25,000.
$25,000.
By $25,000.
Well, $60,900 to $90,400.
Correct.
And that's $25,000?
Yeah, it was $65,400, and we've, so...
Well, it is, these numbers.
Pardon?
It was $65,400.
$65,400 was.
$65,400.
At least that's what I, we voted $65,400.
Right.
$65,400.
That's right.
Yep.
Which is $1,000 more, because it was $2,000, there was sewer, was increased from $1,000 to $2,000.
Gotcha.
Okay. All those in, any further discussion? All those in favor? Aye. Opposed?
No first, no second.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought there was a...
Second.
Who?
You.
I made the motion.
You did?
Yep.
I've got two copies here, does anyone need a copy?
I get John's copy.
Oh, I wondered how you ended up with two, or I was missing. Anyway.
There you go.
I knew I handed out one too many somehow. I did too. Yeah, no, I didn't.
Okay, what would you like us to look over next?
If you don't mind, if you want to go to page three.
On the...
And look at the warrant articles. We did finally get a chance to visit with our DOR representative.
Okay, so what are we looking at?
On page three of this, the summary, the annual town meeting finance committee budget recommendations.
This, yeah.
No.
This.
Do you have a copy?
Yep, that one right there.
Yeah, page three.
And I put this one there too.
So what we were told was that if in fact we have any students that do end up going to Smithfolk and we need to transfer money into that line item, you have to have the line item there to start with. And the only way you can have the line item there to start with is by putting a dollar into it. So the suggestion by DLS or DOR was to put a dollar into that warrant article. And then we'd have the opportunity to do that if we needed to.
If we needed to, yeah, that makes sense.
Now, we don't need to put also a dollar into the sped tuition?
No, because it's all one line item, so I just stuck it on the top line.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you would want to re-vote that one, I think that would be good.
All right. So, anyone have any questions on that? Not, we have a motion. It'll be Article 18, Chapter 74, Smith Vocational Tuition, $1.
So moved.
Second?
I'll second.
It's moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Unanimous?
So, the next thing I'd like to talk about is that ambulance reserve that that you voted against last time that we met last week. And we did get a chance to talk to DOR about that as well. He wasn't avoiding my phone calls, but apparently kept forgetting to call me back.
That sounds like right time of the year to do that.
Well, it was pretty disappointing because we ended up going with somebody else's advice, and that advice is now old school advice, and it shouldn't have been followed.
Understood.
So you were right, Bruce. Our options could have been to put it into a stabilization fund.
Yes.
Apparently, the reserves are being abused, and so are the capital funding, the capital project funds for those kinds of things. So DOR is not recommending or not allowing us to do that anymore, period. Yeah. I think originally Joe had said maybe a stabilization fund, but then he realized that might be a problem with the three towns, so that's why he recommended the capital projects fund, which is...
Yeah, he had a problem with stabilization with two-thirds in, two-thirds out.
Exactly. So DOR said, yes, you could do a stabilization fund, but he said, I understand with the three towns, that's not workable. He said, therefore, your only other option is to leave it in retained earnings. And just every year, note that you have a money set aside within that retained earnings that you will eventually use for the ambulance.
Wait, it's been right long.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a set aside. It's
semi-capital. It's not set aside, but it's within there.
Within, you know, right, yeah. Retained
Zach earnings. Will keep a spreadsheet. He'll keep us informed as to what monies they're holding back for that purpose.
So which article is that?
That would have been in the capital projects article, which would have been Article
13.
Actually, Article 12.
Article 12.
Mm-hmm. Oh, then look at that. And it's all right. You said capital.
Do I have it?
Yeah.
I did have capital requests as Article 13.
Yeah, so
I need to change that. That's Capital 12, or that's Article 12. So then the SCIMS Enterprise Fund is Article 11.
Yes.
Sure enough.
Yeah.
That's changed. Okay, I'll have to change those numbers.
Okay, well,
that's good to know that now.
Let's check them all. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's part of this.
So I didn't even include it as a recommendation or a request We discussed that. Zach said, I'm going to just pull the request altogether for that, and so we didn't even put it in here as requested.
Does it show the balance of retained earnings? Well, in the statement, in his budget.
Just in his internal
Budget.
Spreadsheets, it will say that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, if somebody on the floor asks how much retained earnings is remaining in the account, will he be able to answer that? Or somebody?
I could, yeah, I can have that number in my head.
Thank you.
Are we talking about capital requests now, or just that one?
We were just talking about that one at the moment.
So what we've got here is now is the corrected this?
The article numbers are.
Oh, the next page, yes.
But no, I'm talking about number 11.
Motion?
Number 11 never changed.
Well, I don't know if this is right or not.
Which one?
Article.
Okay, which article?
Retained earnings says it's $284,145.
That's the amount that we are using in the operations budget.
But, okay.
And
so this is the operations budget?
Correct.
Projected 450, zero grants, Deerfield assessment, okay.
Yes. That's the operating budget, so we're using $284,145 for that. And then if you look on page, on the Article 12 then, you're using, if what they've requested is the amount that is going to be.
Yeah.
I see that number is wrong too.
$71,000.
Yep, $71,000.
That's right. But the total.
If that number is approved, the $71,000, that will also be taken out of retained earnings. So what will stay in retained earnings is the $108,000 and the $54,260, which was the
the ambulance.
That was the money that they were setting aside for furniture if they needed it. Furniture and equipment, yeah. I have an incorrect number on there, so that's got to change.
And on the capital request on the Article 12, they already have the $26,000 in for the mower.
I did just to have it
just
in there as a placeholder. I know
there.
You need to vote it yet.
Okay. Yeah.
FinCon needs to vote it, but it was such a difficult spreadsheet to stick in there that, that I thought, well, I better put it in there just so it's in there and I can always take it out.
So
that's
it doesn't
easy.
Get lost in the shuffle.
Right.
That's interesting.
The stretch of load systems, I've heard since that, and it's hearsay, that they can buy reconditioned ones for $10,000.
Why
not
that
brand new?
Money?
Reconditioned.
Not brand new though, right?
Not if it's reconditioned, couldn't they? No.
No, I understand.
And that's why the CIPC, you know, for the record, that's why the CIPC voted for one. It was a rush job.
No, I understand.
Last minute request.
Everything typically is.
And maybe we could have saved some money.
Well, what do we end
Didn't
up retaining?
Didn't you put them through the mill on this one and ask those kinds of questions?
Huh?
Weren't they asked those kinds
of
questions?
No, it was last minute. We got a vote.
It was last minute, and the idea of, unless I don't know where you got the information, but it obviously didn't come from South County EMS.
Well, the reconditioning thing?
Yeah.
No, it's
so.
It's hearsay.
And we never saw the actual bid or quotation from the firm.
No, in fact, they originally in December
had a $25,000.
They had for two of them. And then in June or April, they come in and say, oh no, it should have been
$50,000. Because we wasn't checked. So.
No.
I don't know.
It was two both
I know.
Times.
I know.
Price.
But I don't think they have price either time.
So with the retained earnings on the skims,
that's just for the record.
108 of that retained earnings is earmarked for the ambulance?
Mm-hmm. Just that, internally earmarked.
Right. How that 284,145?
No,
that's what I was wondering.
No, out of the 517,000.
517, okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, you don't have to change your recommendation, and we can continue to look into that issue. Ask the question for the stretcher.
Well, that's if that's what the If that's what the select board wants to do.
Really, it's up to...
CIPC's done its job.
It's up to Carolyn and now the...
Right.
Committee, the oversight committee, to make a decision whether they should buy a recondition and save the town.
Well, this is hearsay.
I'm just saying, if it is true, they need to make a decision whether they want to buy two for 40, if that's what it is.
Right.
Or two for 50. Are they 20,000 each? 10,000 each? Two for 20.
I think it's two for 20.
Two for 20 or two for 50. So that's...
That's the board of oversight.
But that's just an example of rush, rush, rush.
I know, I agree.
Like the roadside mower is rush, rush, rush.
What is that?
It's a lease, too.
What's this roadside mower revolving fund anyway?
That's part of Eversource.
Above the Dickinson cluster.
Eversource, there's five towns, is it, that are community hosts. And every 5 years, one town hosts, and they get a mower from Eversource. And it's to maintain high tension lines.
Yeah.
But it actually goes to the town. Town leases it for 5 years at whatever the cost may be. And...
It's a little bit more.
Right, it's about $28,000. So it's going to cost the town like $10,000 over 5 years. Plus, there's a $500 a year fee for any maintenance on it. And at the end of the 5 years, the mower is given to the town. The other four towns has use of that mower once a year because they're in agreement with Eversource to maintain those high tension lines. I believe it's once a year, I think.
Really?
Well, those are questions we have to, for a 3 week period. Those are questions we have to ask Kevin tomorrow night. That's why I say, like you say, at the last minute, we've got very little information. We're supposed to be voting on this is...
So this lease payment number one of five for the roadside mower?
Yeah.
Is for $26,000?
Yeah.
And the amount...
And the Eversource kicks back.
Yeah, the amount that WMECO is going to give us every year for that mower is $26,000.
But it's going to actually...
Over a period of 5 years.
But it's going to actually cost us $28,000 per year. So it's about $2,000 a year difference there.
All right, so...
And we're supposed to get some money from the other towns or something like that?
Yeah, we got like $500.
That's for me. We ran the mower 1 week out of the summer. 1 week, we're required, 1 week to each town. And he can still choose to do 2 weeks if he wanted to for a couple of towns. But it's $500 is what they give towards that. And then if they break the mower, you know, if there's something...
They fix it.
If they're just negligent with it, they fix it. If it's just regular maintenance, then all towns put in...
Just towns.
No, the towns.
That participate in the share.
Oh, if they break it.
Yeah.
So is it just behind the tractor, the part behind the tractor, or is the tractor mower combo?
It's the combo. From
you
what
just
I understand.
Bought it, bringing the tractor to pull out.
It doesn't cost us anything.
But at the same time,
couple of grand.
But at the same time, if we already have a tractor in town that we own, why
$75,000 for a tractor?
Why do we need two?
Well,
so what are we going to do with that $75,000 tractor? Why do we need two tractors?
We should sell it then.
Maybe we should sell it. That's what the purpose was.
Yeah.
Purpose was to buy that so we could mow.
That's what I thought it was.
That's what I thought. You can't see any of the
new one that Eversource is funding and
that's what I'm saying. Well, that's what I'm saying. Why are we going to house two now?
What's this, some brand new that they just started?
No.
We were involved with it from what I read, which was limited information in a very short period of time. From what I read, we were involved with this program in the early 2000s. And then we dropped out for a while to do our own thing and then realized that it was not really...
this was a good
program. Right,
it
was a good program to be involved with, so they jumped back into it a couple of years ago. And it happened to, on the rotation, happened to come up to be our turn. And Greenfield would be the next host community.
Yeah, so
they've already gone through three other towns.
They didn't know last week if we could be the host community, and there was a meeting held. Greenfield was vying for it, and the other towns agreed to vote for Deerfield.
So what the deal is there's five towns that participate, and all four of the towns already have a mower.
As a result of this.
And Greenfield wanted a second one, and we hadn't ever had one. So there was a drawing as to who was going to be the host for this one, and Deerfield was chosen.
Yeah, because I think we just bought that one last year.
We did.
As a matter of
fact. It was 75, I think.
Yeah, real.
So, well, that's what, and I think those questions need to be asked tomorrow night.
Well, everyone speculates, so yeah. I'm speculating, yeah.
I apologize. Request if you want.
But I thought, and I could be wrong, that the other mower doesn't have the long arm extension this one does. It says other
right.
kinds of capacities
right.
that we don't have currently.
I'm sure it does.
Which is fine, but as I say,
so
if
we can go do the mowing
right.
work.
But the thing is, if we're going to get this mower, then why keep the one we have?
Is it because we need the other one for the cemeteries and things like that? Or is it strictly roadside?
This is a bigger track.
Okay.
You could run a farm one.
I think they.
So my question would be, why keep two and have the house two? And that's a question for Kevin. I mean, there might be legitimate reasons. Who knows? But I don't know that at this point.
Yeah, he says on the. You're welcome to have a copy of this, Bruce. This is the request. It says sometime around 2012, the town pulled out of the program and voted to buy a roadside mower with town funds. It was approved.
Yeah.
But didn't.
No.
I don't think they
bought it. In 12, we did.
Oh, they.
But in 14, we bought it, or 15.
Did we? Maybe we didn't buy it.
Maybe
I don't
it was
know.
Just delivered last year, though.
Yeah, because Kip
do they have
wanted
it?
Them to send it back. It was a joint
right.
deal.
Right. So that maybe just got delivered last year. Yeah,
this year, 16. Last year.
Well, 60 grand. Well, now she knows it.
I'd have to go look it up.
That's right. It's a John Deere.
I remember it
being
John
Deere. Well, maybe Kip would know.
I heard you're selling a tractor. That's a good deal.
Yeah. You want to buy one?
I don't know. The radio only was worth $650. I would have got a better one.
We're just wondering as far as the two tractors. If we just purchased one recently and now we're going to end up with another tractor.
Yeah, but I can tell you what you're going to hear. Well, the new tractor has a boom that will go over the guardrails. So we're going to stop doing what we're doing down there. I've been looking through the invoice, and that's exactly what they're buying these expensive parts to build stuff.
Right.
So I guess one way around.
But yeah, we just don't need two.
No, we don't need the old tractor.
The old tractor is a new tractor. It's a two
tractor. We can sell it.
So why can't we sell it? If we're going to get this tractor from...
Canadian tractor, false, $70,000.
Yeah.
If we're going to get this tractor from Eversource...
No, it wasn't $70,000. It was
$90,000. Yeah.
Well, it's on the books. Well, you know why? Because he took a whole bunch of other stuff and traded it in.
Well, okay. That's okay.
Well, whatever.
Well,
I don't know.
Right. And why do you have to house two tractors?
Right.
Probably the
new tractor. Going to use that 8,500 square foot garage.
The tractor that we would get probably doesn't have a loader on it. And I saw them putting leaves in it this morning over at the library. I mean, most people use a wheelbarrow or something like that. We use a $90,000 tractor. And it was running it really. I won't say because she's here, but went up my backside. Why don't you shut it off?
It's a diesel. We don't have to shut
it off. We just have to start it back up again.
I don't pay for the fuel.
Okay. So that'll be a question for CIP.
Those are just great questions we'll have to ask.
All right, what else do we need to talk about? Can we go over this?
Sure. By the way, the articles were right. The article numbers on my report, we found out that the warrant that Wendy gave you a copy of has two Article 2s on it.
Okay.
I think until she gets that fixed, I won't look at that again. But yes.
Yeah, it could be a little.
So is this what's going to be available to the voters?
Yes. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't bring you a copy.
Oh, that's right. I just sitting there listening to
actually,
my other.
Actually, there's another one here.
Sorry.
Okay.
There is one here if you'd like.
Recommended is per FinCom, right? That's what that
yes.
column means?
Yes.
This is our budget recommendation.
This is our recommendation.
And they did just vote the town office building for $90,400.
Oh, I know what one I want to take a look at. Street lights. You guys had decided that you wanted to try for $35,000?
I think that was right.
Can we leave it at 40 and just stay there, and then if, you know?
It doesn't really matter to me. We're going to try to talk with the power company to get them to either sell us LED lights or mm-hmm. install them or whatever and go from there.
Yeah.
The reason that, one of the reasons that the discussion went to lowering it is because the rate that we're now paying for electricity was down about 7% from what we paid last year. And hopefully, fairly soon, we're going to be getting those credits from solar field off of River Road.
Yeah.
And that should save us close to another 20% if everything I was told was correct. So.
But that how does that credit come back to us?
I don't know. Well, if the credit off of the bill, it comes to us in income, so it won't affect it. The expense will still be there.
I think we have to designate what buildings on account it's credited to, though.
I don't know.
That's what I thought.
I think it's a paperwork thing that, you know, we get these credits and then you can apply it toward the bill. I don't think you get a discounted bill. You get the bill the same, but you mail in a credit along with your check or something like that.
Okay.
That's how it
okay.
Works. Which one are you talking about? The parts or the?
The solar field one.
Oh, the solar field. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, they did ask for bills, and I sent them bills per building. There's two different things. There's the good energy.
Right. That's not what
I think. Well, that's what what you're describing made me think of how they were.
No, good energy is they want to know about building, but we're getting solar credits up to, I want to say,
bills.
I don't know if it was 45 or 75,000 a year from the solar.
That was an estimate.
Was that?
That was an estimate based on so many kilowatts that we had to use. We had to use so many kilowatts in that contract. We guaranteed to them that we would use so many kilowatt hours.
We being the town.
We being the town.
We get, 6%?
I think somebody needs to read the contract.
Well, yeah, we get paid in a lot of different ways.
It would help.
Then we get that payment in lieu of taxes.
But
we also get those credits.
Right.
So.
Yeah, I sent them bills.
It's 9 cents a kilowatt hour, I think, is what we contracted for.
Well, somewhere along
so many kilowatt hours.
Brenda will have some responsibility.
Good energy.
No,
nope.
It's over here on River Road.
But that's going to be your responsibility to figure out how that works.
I don't know, Bruce. Yeah.
I thought it was the percentage as well as the five or six other municipal or quasi-municipal entities that are involved in this. Each get a percentage. It's not necessarily linked into it's ours.
We didn't know anybody else at that point in time.
Well, he mentioned when he called me for these bills, yeah. He named off a few other.
Yes, so we're putting it towards certain.
Yes, he wanted the bills for the
certain buildings.
Yeah.
Because we had to. It had
and
to
you
add
sent,
total
sent street lights as well, correct?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So
I thought.
Sent that off.
Speaking of street lights, I
give you all the
talked with Kippy, and he doesn't have a problem with, at least at the moment, with leaving it at 40. And I talked with Carolyn, and I've talked with Trevor, so they're all in basic agreement. Now, tomorrow
they
morning,
need to
they may change.
Yeah, they need to revote that. They voted their meeting.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that's certainly the safe way to go.
Because that's always one where we've tended to under budget that for whatever reason.
So I realized that the formatting of this, the articles did get off kilter. Oops, there were two article twos, so everything is up a number after two. The second article two should be article three and then go from there.
Mm-hmm. Under the On page three of this, Brenda,
mm-hmm.
at the end, we've got totals.
He took mine.
And then...
Did he? Oh, no, I gave him an extra.
And then it says, I move to the town appropriate, and it says $0 to fund this, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Right. Because there's been nothing voted yet. Right here.
We voted.
Oh, yeah.
Mosquito district.
No, but town meeting has not voted it. So, this is one of those.
Okay.
It calculates it as we vote it.
And the raise and appropriate will come up to the...
Yes.
That $196,000 is the sum of these items here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where are you on that?
Right here. That's a negative $196,000 sitting there.
Okay.
So that's from tax.
When I move down, the Siemens energy loan, that was repaid last year, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's zero. Correct. That's right, zero.
Montague legal defense is no longer on there?
Right. That's no. Why those are there, because FY17 is
gotcha.
Listed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was part of FY17.
Zero requested, zero recommended. So zero requested from mosquito control 11.
Zero requested
as a special article.
Correct.
But it's in a budget line.
Right.
Which budget has the mosquito?
512, 5400.
Yeah,
that does show 11,000 less.
Right.
Okay.
512, 5400. So
there's an $11,000 difference.
Who's going to speak to that? Who wants to stand up and defend
the reduction?
The right.
We'll let Kippy do that.
No, well,
it's not his reduction.
No, so somebody, it's somebody here.
And
so I'm looking through the other one was.
And the Board of Health wants the money. Carolyn wants the 11,000.
What's our reason for not?
Mosquitoes.
Mosquitoes. We just didn't feel like we need to spend the $11,000 on the mosquitoes.
Spend anything on ticks, you tell you,
right.
You wash your hands, you stay away from ticks. And, you know, if it's education, I mean, fine, you know, but when chasing mosquitoes down the road.
When Carolyn puts a hold on it, and she's going to say, we need the 11,000, so who's going to debate?
I'm going to say, I would say at this point, we should let the townspeople make the decision. So. We made a decision that it was not in the best interest of the town to spend the money.
So who's going to say that?
Chair.
I'm not going to stand up on all of these things. And
there's only one, two. I'm trying to find the other one.
What's another one?
The other one is the planning board.
Planning board, I'll be glad to do that.
So would I. But I want somebody to talk about the mosquitoes.
Planning board.
I have to do capital stuff. So.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
John Pachurk will do mosquitoes.
Oh. Did you find out anything more about that planning board? Can that be used? I know there was some discussion at the select board meeting on that.
On what it could be used for? I don't know. I thought Wendy was going to look into that, but maybe not.
It's pretty vague, the description of
well,
it.
So there's only two items we said.
It is,
no,
and the key is, like I said at the last meeting, the expenditures have to relate to the income.
We couldn't get.
Yeah. And we get income from ANRs and other applications.
Reduced.
So I just processed a bill through the revolving fund, which is part of our contract with FERCOG, our yearly contract with FERCOG.
Yeah.
And I processed that through the revolving fund, and Wendy approved it.
That's
so.
What I saw.
That's the only one that's on here. There's a difference. So.
Well,
but she was thinking there were some other expenses.
I just went through them all.
I don't know.
Looking at totals.
I mean,
total for each department, they're all the same except for
test wall monitoring maintenance. It came in at $90,000 on that.
Which was where?
Right here.
What page are you looking at?
So,
oh, test wall.
And Kevin reduced his request to $70,000.
Yeah, but we had nothing to do with that.
It was approved in 2017 at 90,000.
What are you looking at?
I was just asking what we actually turned, what we reduced the budget from.
Test number one was the mosquito.
No, test well monitoring came in at 90,000. That was the original request.
The totals on here are all the same.
You're right, because I sat and spent time with Kevin and got him to reduce it to 70,000, so we don't have.
To request it down.
Yes, so that he came down and.
But the committee did not. We have 70,000 in front of us and we voted.
That's right.
Okay, gotcha.
Otherwise, we would have had a $90,000 one to look at, so.
That's a good question.
So do we need to speak for it?
No.
No, because his request shows not 70. And that was in a.
Kevin was okay with that.
So it's just the one item?
And there were a couple others that came on.
Planning board.
And the planning board.
Well, the planning board.
We had 1,000, they wanted 6.
Pardon?
Given all this stuff?
So speaking of the planning board, did we decide what we needed the line item for the appropriation?
I was going to compare all the totals.
Because you and I just ran that one bill through.
Right.
The revolving fund.
So where's the planning board?
$15,000 that we can get.
175, 54.
Front page.
Front page.
And that, how we figure revolving versus non-revolving.
So the select board said $6,000 last night?
They did.
Or whenever it was last week?
Yeah, frankly, I'm not sure that's even going to be enough, depending on what we can sort out in terms of revolving fund.
Two of the select board.
Yes. And we thought they should be using revolving funds.
And the revolving fund is limited. It's not, we can't use it for all the services that we're getting. It can just be used for applicant fees related to specific projects and specific kinds of services related to that.
What we spent is minimal out of that line.
So what's your history of expenses out of it?
Minimal.
Generally, we've been the yearly contract with FERCOG has been coming out of the revolving fund, some of that. I don't know that we've had any other. I'd have to look at the history.
So I guess my question is, if you make this revolving fund permanent with this article, does that mean that money has to stay there forever?
Well, it's allowed to now. There's no
Right now, if you don't renew the revolving fund prior to the fiscal year, the funds revert back into the general fund.
Right, and town meeting would still vote the fund every year, even with the change that we're proposing.
Right, but what I'm saying is
once it's in the bylaw.
Once it's in the bylaw.
How do you get rid of that particular revolving
fund? You have this $20,000 in that you can't spend and you can't put it back in that general fund.
Well, can you put it back in the general fund if the town meeting doesn't approve it?
Well, we don't have to approve it anymore. We just approve the spending limits.
Oh, it's the limit, right.
So if all we're doing is approving spending limits, don't know the answer.
Yeah, so if you put it in zero, it means it has to stay in the $20,000. Mm-hmm. So it sounds like you need to terminate the fund and allow that to come back in
by
and reappropriate
your bylaw
it for a smaller amount.
To take it out.
Right. Can we put a cap on it? But it can't exceed $10,000.
Well,
$15,000.
I don't think so. Not with a 53E and a half. 53D, yes, but not a 53E and a half.
You can cap the amount of spending on it, but you can't cap the.
What's carried over?
What's carried over? You basically, the way it is right now, if you don't renew it prior to the end of the year, those funds revert back to the general fund.
Right, I understand.
But with this bylaw that's coming in there, that makes that revolving fund
permanent.
So it's and not, the money will so, come back to the general fund.
Right. So the only
so
way
it's locked in there can only be spent out.
The only way you could do that now would be to have an article to terminate that revolving fund.
Let's look into this because it doesn't make any sense that they would have done this. DOR had a heavy hand in this change happening. We have the memo from them.
Oh, no, I'm just bringing this up for a question.
Right.
I don't expect anybody to answer it right this second.
Right, and it bothered me too. I thought putting it in a bylaw, I didn't quite get that. So.
Okay, speaking of
we will look into that.
Revolving funds.
Yes.
The
okay, if we're going on that line, I suppose.
Well,
Sorry, this is a puzzle.
The school resource officer.
Combination.
Speeding. What?
Get a prize for getting there first.
Spending.
The money that goes in there. Who gets to appropriate that money out of there? And on what purposes?
Police department. So it says right
there. It doesn't have to be appropriated, but the police department can spend out of there based on what they have the donations for.
What if it's a general donation?
General donations will go into the general fund.
You mean the police department or?
It's $10,000 by the police.
The police department has a donations fund, so they can put general donations into that account.
The $15,000 that's in Frontier's budget is not a donation.
Right.
That should not go into that fund.
15 or is it more?
Is it for the school resource officer?
Yes.
Well, then it'll go into that fund, because that's what it's designated for.
Then why did we budget $45,000 or $50,000 for a school resource officer in the police department's budget?
I agree. That's why I asked.
That should have been offset.
Well, I know I've stated this before, but you can't always be guaranteed that they're going to give you that money. What if they decide in the end they're not going to because they have some other expenses? So then, if he doesn't have it in his line item budget, and he expects to pay it out of the resource officer fund, and he doesn't have any money, then what does he do? So he can't. I mean, if the money was, if the money was in the account, if he had hundreds of thousands of dollars in that fund already, then I'd say, then yeah, it makes sense. But he doesn't have that money there. They're promising it, but that doesn't mean that it's going to happen.
Well, let me ask you, let's step back with it. I mean, you hate to micromanage everything, but you know, some of this stuff, after some things that have happened, additional funding should be put in a reserve fund, and if it doesn't come through, that would be an unanticipated expenditure, which could come through the Finance Committee and reappropriate it.
But didn't we fully fund the resource officer anyway?
We did. We fully funded it.
So it's a moot point. All these monies are not going to be used.
Right. So that's what I'm saying is pull the funding off the $75,000 off the resource officer. Or whatever it is.
That was what it was intended to do.
Right.
But we fully funded the resource officer in the police department.
In the police budget. So now you have.
Because he's under in the union, contracted employee, under a union contract. So this fund is money that comes into the police department and they can spend it on whatever they want.
And that's why I would like.
They used it, supposedly, they used it to fund the motorcycle.
Yes. I didn't see where the motorcycles were listed in there as being a resource officer.
Me either.
But he's changed that. He's now taken the money for the motorcycle out of some different funds.
We said it was coming out of donations when he met with us.
Which is fine.
Which is okay.
I'm not even sure that I would care if it comes out of the resource. But someplace along the way, we have, at least for Frontier, we've asked Frontier to help support the cost of the resource officer. And they put $15,000 into it.
I thought it was 25.
Or whatever the number is.
15 is a small amount. In fact, I think there's even less than that.
So it now goes into something that becomes a slush fund. And I've got a problem with slush funds.
Well, and here's the other issue here. The money in those revolving funds can't be spent until the income is there. I'm not trying to defend John, but I'm trying to understand why he did things the way he did, and that's that's the way I see it, and it makes
sense. And we're not putting you on the spot for that, okay? We're just throwing out. This is just general conversation.
I've already told you I'm not going to get that $45,000.
So, you know, just know, and I know this from having other opportunities working with school resource officers, DARE programs, et cetera, that this is an account that's used not just for the salary and whatever, which you say is already in the contract anyway, but for all other kinds of things that they do.
And so is all of the other.
So this goes to all kinds of community policing type things related to, especially related to kids in schools and educational and doohickeys.
Budget it. Well, if he needs it, budget it.
Well, let's go one step further. Can we recommend that be used for wages only?
Yeah. That was the idea of it. That was the concept of it, was to offset the salary. The $15,000 from Deerfield Academy, and then this from Frontier.
And there again, it's only a one-year thing, because the next year you can change the directive.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, so I mean, it's not like you're doing this for the next 50 years. This isn't, you know, the fund will exist until it's rebuilt, but there is, you know, how it's funded.
What was discussed and reported was that if the medical marijuana comes online, that the fees will fund that resource officer completely.
Yeah.
That was the game plan on this. And that's how it was sold to the town.
They'll go into this fund.
Right.
There's actually a public safety, the public safety account was to,
accept that.
I thought that was what that was for.
Yes, the top thing,
which is the public health and safety.
Yeah.
Who's the resource officer?
Brian Reeves.
What's in here?
Brian Reeves.
It's got $54,000 in the budget.
Yeah, I know.
Right, but then you've got
overtime. He's got.
And if you put any money through any one of these revolving funds, you have to put the salary and all of the benefits as well.
Yeah,
you can't put just the salary through.
Right.
So
I guess that would be my recommendation, to change that for wages only.
But then do we still have the 54 in there?
Uh-huh. Well, the 54 should stay there. What I wanted to see on the bottom of it was something that says minus $45,000.
Yeah.
You know, I do understand the argument that's being made that what if we don't get it?
And you can't spend until you do get it. So what if they don't pay you until June next year?
It's a real conundrum.
John takes care of the conundrum.
It makes it hard for John.
No.
I'm not losing any sleep over how difficult it makes it.
We're on television.
Look here.
Well, personally, I'd like to see a little bit different on all these revolving funds. I just don't see having public health and safety a $250,000 limit with only the select board, because is that the select board or board of health? For both my question. In this particular situation, it happened to be one of the same. In this town, but is this, and I would like to know what is in line for $250,000, and or my recommendation would be to knock that down to some reasonable figure, and because the 53.5 does allow for upping that figure with conjunction with the Finance Committee.
I was going to say, where it says authority to spend funds, does that need to be select board?
No, it does not need to be select board.
Doesn't need to be anybody.
It does not.
Well, you have to have something there.
Yeah, well,
somebody
yeah.
has to have the authority to spend those funds.
As long as it meets the stipulation of the use of the fund.
Well, exactly.
Well, service activities and expenses related to public health, but that's, there again,
it could be a mosquito control district.
That's I didn't want to say that, but.
Well, I will.
Say what?
Mosquito control district, public health.
Yeah.
I mean,
Just remember again, you can't spend any money out of any of these until you have the money received for that, and you have to follow what the intent of the donor is. What is the intent of the person that gave you the donation? That's something that you're held to.
What if they say I give $10,000 to the town for public health and safety?
Then it goes generally into that, and
goes into that, and they can do whatever they want.
At their discretion.
Usually, my experience, this kinds of funds are, that kind of a donation gets targeted. Maybe not so much with the police, with the resource officer.
I mean, I think that's extremely targeted, the resource officer. That's my problem. It's not being used for that. That was for salary, wages, and benefits.
Well, probably should have said in related, and programs related to. But it does say that in the use of funds, so.
And in all reality.
It's the name of the fund, but look at use of funds. Look at the language in use of funds.
I understand, but, well, you know, I would argue with the use of funds. Then, however you put it. Those who, for the resource officer, those funds have been solicited as far, my understanding, those funds were solicited for salary and benefits.
I don't know. I mean, I assume I know so much of the money for these programs goes into, as I, what I was saying earlier, educational materials, promotional materials, activities, et cetera. So, you know, I'm assuming that, but I'm just saying what I think.
Well, they're only funding the person during a school session, right?
Yeah, but...
Then they're regular policemen during the out-of-school session?
Yes.
Well, they do, they do other kinds of
they
activities.
They do summer programs, too?
I think, I know well, they do community-based...
Those schools are in session up here, so...
I know.
You know, so...
Yeah, but...
I would imagine there's some. They're probably not as full-time as there is during the school year, but...
Is it in the town report, the kind of activities?
I don't know.
Look for that. That's where it might be, so...
The roadside mower there, that's $35,000 we got for that. On that.
I just plugged in a figure that was higher than the $26,000 because I knew we would have expenses against it, like maintenance, you know, things that get broken on it, and
okay, that, and that's specifically targeted for that mower, not the second one we have.
Oh yeah.
Oh no, it's specifically for this mower program.
Okay.
Yeah, and I don't even know that this is the right form of fund to put it in. I'm waiting for an answer back from DOR. So we put it in here just initially, just so it was in here, because this is where I think he's going to say we need to put it.
Yeah,
but
we had an initial conversation with him, and he wanted to check, I think.
He did, yeah. He wanted to check on it.
Because it's such an odd kind of a situation.
So the money, the $26,000, we use the $26,000, comes into the town annually,
mm-hmm.
and then it just goes right back out. So this right. is it's just a paper trail is all of the amounts still.
Right.
So and there's to get it into
a little
the
negative cash.
Well,
bit,
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. You might say the operating plan.
Yeah, and the goal is to get it also onto the CRPC.
Capital factor.
Yeah.
So.
To have an inventory of it.
So it's pretty much a self-sufficient type of, it really is.
Pretty close.
Closer to self-sufficiency than most of the rest of these. So.
Oh, yeah.
So is there really any expectation that public health and safety would get $250,000? I think that's already way near that.
I don't know that. I put that in there because that's what they put in the annual town meeting minutes for the last couple of years. When they set it up, I don't know what the intent was.
There's the marijuana income.
Well, I think part of it.
Well, yeah, that,
yeah,
I mean, that's
so much percent.
Is it part of that marijuana agreement that is going to go back? So that, I think that's where they plan on picking up a lot of it.
Yeah.
And I'm just concerned. I don't like that. I'm
very much concerned.
What's the concern?
I don't think you should be $250,000 on the table without oversight.
I think it should be much less than that. And
I started out with
putting the stabilization fund, let townspeople vote to put it back in there.
Well, you don't even have to, because the 53.5 allows the finance committee to do that. Because, well,
where does it sit, though?
Huh?
Where does the money sit?
This'll...
If we get
any
a lump
of these,
sum
funds. Any of these go into a fund, regardless of what it is, okay? If they get $500,000,
right.
it goes into that fund.
Right.
Okay, the cap... You set the cap, and if you set it for $5,000,
yes,
then the finance committee, they say, hey, $5,000 is enough.
Right.
The finance committee has the right to come in and sit down and authorize work and whoever it is and say, okay, all right, we agree with you, we're going to raise it up to $50,000. So it just comes back out of the fund.
Yeah.
The fund, it hasn't gone into.
Right. Gotcha.
You know, the hall of no return type of situation.
So the spending limit is the biggest question.
You're right. The money doesn't disappear. It doesn't go, it can't be spent for other things and so forth, but it just, you know, a little bit of oversight for a huge number.
Are you suggesting adding the finance committee to the authority to spend funds on all of these items?
No,
Well, that automatically in 53 and a half.
Okay.
Okay, what I'm suggesting is dropping that limit down to, I don't know, 25, 50,000, something like that.
So what happens is if they want to spend more than what this limit is that's voted at town meeting, you're saying the finance, I didn't remember who had the authority to give them the higher limit, but that you're saying the finance committee.
The finance committee.
I thought they had to go back to town meeting.
No.
Yeah, I didn't think they had to go back to town meeting, but.
Okay.
Okay. Let's see. Revolving fund shall be established pursuant to all that board of department authorized. The establishment, let's see.
BC?
B3.
Section BC. Oh, looking at the motion mirrors the language given by the Department of Revenue, so the bottom of the language.
Oh, yeah.
So if you look at BC, is that what you're referring to?
Okay, the city or town shall honor before July 1st of each year, vote on the limit of the total amount that may be expended from each revolving fund established under this section. In any fiscal year, the limit on the amount that may be spent from a revolving fund may be increased with the approval of the city council and mayor in a city, or with the approval of the board of selectmen and finance committee in a town.
Right, which is captured in BC.
And finance committee.
Right.
Oh, and it is, yeah, you're right, it is here.
So that means jointly.
And it's right here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Or any increased amount of that is later approved during that fiscal year by the select board and finance committee.
So, you know, that won't screw with, you know, any of these ones.
So we should author. So if it's over, this only kicks in if it's over 250,000.
Right.
So that's why we want the limit to be lower.
Right.
I agree. We don't want a quarter million dollars.
Right.
Expenditure without any checks and balances.
Yeah. And the other thing that concerns me is the overall issue is what happens to that money there again. You basically have to go town meeting and dissolve the fund to recoup that into the general fund?
I would assume if we're going to make a bylaw change, right?
Yeah.
Mr. Town meeting for that?
Yeah.
So that holds true with any of these funds, not just that.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So this could be recommended at town meeting floor as a change in the spending limit, or
well, this is just a motion, so these can all change. These aren't set in stone. This is,
we'll talk about it tomorrow night.
Yeah, I was gonna say if you want it to be less than that,
The Parks and Recreation seems awful high too. I mean, that's a. Do you have any idea what their past trend has been?
I know I've looked at that in the past, and 75,000 was a little higher than what she was spending, but it wasn't a huge difference. So.
But she is turning over that much.
She has a lot of programs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I guess the two I'm concerned with is the public health and safety and school resource.
Yeah, I'm concerned about the planning board.
Yeah, well.
But the parks and recreation it's just got the, well, I guess it's because I never mind. Was that a revolving fund? Never mind. Mm-hmm.
She's pretty frugal.
On these funds, what restrictions, let's take parks and recreation, what restrictions are there on that revolving fund?
She's a department head, so she chooses, she submits bills just like any other department head for the things that she needs. And she, I know Sue is very careful. She's got it broken into 25 different activities, and she watches the income that comes in versus what she spent to know how she's doing.
But are there limits on what the money can be spent for?
Well, it has to be reasonable within, you know. Okay.
It's pretty, the language is here.
Activities and expenses related to providing recreational activities.
Right.
Well, with that kind of open-end thing, you could buy a car and ride it back and forth.
I know, I agree.
She wouldn't approve that.
I would not approve that. I was going to say, you have a town accountant for it.
Here's a major check and balance right here.
That was one of my questions.
Thank you, Brenda. No, but I'm just saying, that's what the definition says, though.
She's second in power to the Board of Health.
So this is...
Seriously.
Well, she's supposed to be that way.
I know. No, I'm saying it, that's the law.
So we to make this fund to be 75, to have $75,000 in it, we must take in more than we expect.
We generally do.
Not less.
Not much, but some.
She's saying that they do turn that much over, so.
No,
they don't turn anything over.
Well, they turn it around.
The income,
they roll around close to 75,000.
Now she has to get the income first, right?
Right.
Before she can spend it.
Right. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm concerned.
Just like the resource.
But she has money in there now, so it's not like it's a huge.
That's what I'm getting.
Right now, I think she has about 30,000 as a balance in that.
Okay.
She started with 20, when this moved into a 53E and a half.
Yeah. So what if she brings in more money?
She can go up to 75,000. Well, then she has to come to us to spend.
If she needs to spend more than 75,000.
Yeah. But the issue is she probably never will, because we take in more than we expect, more likely.
Well, no, it's a spending limit, so she can't spend more than 75,000 without your approval.
No, if she takes in 85,000.
It doesn't matter. She still can't spend more than 75,000.
Right, so now the fund's grown 10,000.
Right, mm-hmm. Fund just grows.
Right, fund just grows. Well, then when the fund gets to
after
be...
After she spends 75, it's down to 10.
No.
Right.
She has to be kicking around right
well,
now.
Well, if you brought in 85 well, and you spent 75, you've had 10 sitting in there.
Oh, yeah.
And so the 30,000 that's sitting in there now, that would have been, that's over a number of years.
Yes.
Right. So now the fund's up to 40.
What happens when it gets to 75? Right. What happens when it gets to 75?
It just keeps growing.
It just keeps growing.
But this is only
funds grow.
This is only 1 year.
Right.
Yeah.
The fund grows over 75. Like
it still keeps growing. It
could be $100,000.
And that's what we're going back to that question before. Right. You know, you just terminated the fund if you want. Now you have to have you've got to change a bylaw. So, to remove some of that fund and,
right. Because, I mean, funds shouldn't be growing at such a rate that they don't need that excess.
They outpace the budget, right.
Isn't letting them grow too far before they
spend them. That's right.
Their own decision making.
But we have...
The Recreation Commission decision.
Well, these are all 53 and a half, okay?
Yeah, right.
I guess...
The ones, not her, about the department, the board.
They can actually be used. Now, the Park and Recreation could actually be used to pay part of her salary to start it as well.
We were just talking about that.
You know, because, if you get, you know, 30,000, you can't do it with that, because that's, you know, you've got to have a seat.
No, but maybe...
But
maybe
if it does grow up to the 75,000 somewhere down the road, you could pull out,
maybe in
500 hours or something
Well, why couldn't you offset 2 months of her salary against that every year?
That's what I was thinking
about.
That's
my problem with all of these.
Yeah. So
they can be used to reduce the operating budget.
So,
I think if it's on our budget sheet,
well, in this case,
is this
it is the
money
operating.
There.
That is so, the operating budget.
We could use it for salary.
On how
salary
much
and fringes. Salary and fringes.
We can reduce the budget by $75 if we don't
on other
that.
Stuff. Mm-hmm. It could be used to offset our wage.
Right. Or offset anything else in the budget.
Well, there again, none of us
in the budget.
There is nothing in the budget other than this. And its benefits are not
in that budget, I don't think, either, are they? There's just the salary.
In her specific line item, it's just the salary.
It's, she's not full-time, but...
No, she is not full-time.
So, do you have to be a full-time?
I believe she works like 34 hours a week.
Right, but do you have to be a full-time employee, or can you pay what, because it, I remember this being a question from years ago, and specifically, I, you know, I knew there was a lot of, in terms of...
Okay, yeah, but I'm gonna get the detail.
Okay. Forty-five, eighty-eight.
Thirty-four, five, one, one, oh. I don't have it.
I mean, it just...
That's all right. Yeah, it's just their wage.
Yeah.
I know, it implies it could be part-time.
Yeah, it's just her wage. That's not even fringe.
So if we knew in the bottom of that block, saying there's X amount of dollars in the reserve fund currently, and last year FY '17 was $30,000, FY '16 was $20,000, looks like it's increasing at $10,000 a year, maybe we can use $10,000.
Yeah. I agree.
See, the basic agreement that, that was reached with the Recreation Department years ago, and don't ask me who was on the board at that point in time, whether it was just the select board, or it was just the finance committee, or a combination of select board and the finance committee, is that the town would pay the salary of the director, and the rec committee and the director would be responsible for raising the funds to pay for the programs. So, it wasn't written down anywhere, but that was the general understanding that we had.
Of this one we have right now, the Parks and Rec.
Right.
Which is, yeah, I think we're just using that for an example at this point, you know, because, but it just says if you do it for full-time employees, you have to pay wages. So,
right.
I guess the other way around, for part-time, you wouldn't have to pay the fringes.
That's what it looks like. That's what it looks like to me.
If you read the other way, you know, uh-huh. What it doesn't say, it says you're just part-time, you don't have to pay the fringes, only the salary.
And is she considered part-time? What's full-time for the town of Deerfield?
Full-time is full-time.
40, okay.
Well,
37 and a half.
They don't define, 40.
40?
40, supposedly 40.
Okay.
But what would you do with somebody who works less than 40 hours a week?
They can get benefits, depend, you know, with the 18 or 20.
Percentage.
I don't know what it is.
At 20, as a 20, they can
get benefits. So once you have 20, but that doesn't necessarily make you full, you know, between 20 and 40 is not full-time.
Yeah, they have prorated benefits.
So somebody who's working, say, 35 hours a week.
It's prorated benefits.
Yeah.
But they aren't.
It will depends on what benefit it is. They get full health insurance, but they don't get
holidays,
they get prorated
sick days,
holidays,
all prorated.
And leave time is prorated.
Unless it's contracted.
Unless it's contracted, right. But contracts generally mirror the language. Where
not
are we
four,
going?
Not a 4-2 work week.
It's not a what? Oh, you're thinking of the police?
The police department.
Uh-huh.
It's not a 40-hour.
It is not. What is it?
I don't know. Take 5 minutes to figure it out. It's a little less than that. They work 4 days on, 2 days off, 4 days on, 2 days off. So it's 60 cycles. We call it 61 cycles a year. 61 times 4, 8 times 4, 32. 61 times, what's 61 times 32?
Yeah. 61 times 432?
61 times 32.
1952.
1952?
Yeah, so.
Yep.
As opposed to 2088.
Right. Mm-hmm. 130 hours less.
So take the 1952 and divide it by 52.
4 weeks less.
37.54.
24.
But that's, you know, that's a contract.
Yep. Okay. So.
And presumably, you know, the argument with teachers that I'm not going to get into, but there, that's a salary position with teachers. Okay, so where else are we going with this? So we have questions. I don't know that we have any solutions or answers to these things.
Right.
And I don't know whether we'll find solutions or answers between now and next month.
So, can we go back to this? You all right?
Yep.
Sure.
How much free cash are we going to be left with when we're done?
$587,000.
After the...
Sorry, that's on one of the other sheets I gave you last week.
But it should have changed. It would have changed, though, right?
No, it only changed by a dollar, and the $25,000 that we added to the maintenance. You're right, so yeah.
$25,000 more.
Or $25,000 less is what we're leaving on the table, so yeah, it used to be in the $600,000 range. $587,000 is what we're leaving on the table.
So if you take off...
Minus $25,000.
Call it $550,000 for round figures.
No, that includes the $25,000 taken out.
Okay.
Oh, it does include the $25,000?
You know, the $587,000 figure that we're leaving on the table is actually based on the requested amount at this point.
Okay.
So until we actually vote on everything, I wanted to make sure that if in fact all the requested numbers were considered, that we had enough free cash left. So.
I don't think we got a chance to discuss all of this last week. The revenue detail, the overlay surplus of $100,000.
That's what they're giving us. Mm-hmm.
You know that?
Assessors. Yes, I have a letter.
Yep, that's been voted.
Okay, all right.
Yes.
Correspondence.
They gave you a what?
I sent one back.
we always send a letter over to the office when I was there. Karen always did. Let's put it back.
Okay. Anything else?
Did you need to vote on the mower, or are you waiting for CIPC?
I'm not sure.
I don't know how that works.
You meeting tomorrow night?
Yeah.
Because I have it in here.
But we can do it. I mean, FinCon can do its own vote.
I know, but typically, you know, we give deference to the, you know, to allow you to do your job before we do ours. I mean, there's not much sense in us voting either in favor or opposed to it if you haven't taken it up. It's like, I guess you turn around and say, well, why do we
bother?
Well,
you did for the church. You did for the stretch of load systems.
Well, no.
We had voted.
After, yes, right. And we ended up voting something
right.
different. But
right.
we
church. Right waited for the capital improvement. Right now,
that was
until I have some questions answered, I wouldn't be able to vote anyway.
Well, it's a committee too.
Right.
What? You know.
You
and I can discuss what we think, but
right. It wouldn't make
this 500 people.
Right. Exactly.
Someone had suggested that be in under capital items, not the maintenance of the building, but the building.
But that's what that is. It's maintenance.
I know. But I'm just saying that's...
Okay. At some point, that will have to be addressed.
Right.
So going back, before we go ahead, we never got off of this.
Right.
What is the committee going to recommend as far as these? Just the way you're written, or is it going to recommend a lesser amount?
Which one's that person?
Well, we start with the public health and safety, right off the bat.
Well, I think we should definitely set limits. I agree with you.
I think we should also...
What article was that before? Was there always Article 1?
The revolving funds?
Yeah. We didn't even talk about
it. It didn't have a chart prior to this.
No, it did not have a chart.
Yeah. It's the same chart you've been voting other than the roadside number for several years.
Yeah, well, the public health, I just didn't believe came
yeah,
in last year.
Yeah, that might have been.
Okay,
yeah.
So...
I guess as to what the monies could be, and that's a changing environment too. So
I guess I would like to see under use of funds non-capital service activities and expenses, and with a cap on the amount.
Well, cap is too quick. You want to change the cap?
Yes, I would.
I agree.
We're here as a committee.
You want to make a motion, Bruce?
Okay, I would make a motion that under use of, under public health and safety, under use of funds, we add the word non-capital to read non-capital service activities and expenses related to providing public health and safety services. And the amount under the fiscal year be changed to $50,000.
I'll second that.
To how much, 50?
50, yeah.
So you're saying change that spending limit to 50,000?
Yep.
How much is in?
And you're also saying...
No.
Under use of funds, add the words non-capital.
I think John spent it today.
Because once it goes to revolving funds, we have, it doesn't go before CRTC or anything.
Well, we got a $25,000 donation, so we've spent basically $25,000.
Now they want $250.
Well, it always was at $250 since it started.
Then it was. How about changing the spending authority to capital expenses with the approval of the capital improvement committee? Or something like that.
Oh, not to, we're doing non-capital.
Which serves also as the unmarked police car.
Which would bring in the finance committee.
Motion for discussion.
Yeah.
John did. Second.
So we have a motion for not, to add non-capital, so they can't buy anything that's capital item.
Define capital, that's my concern, is that we have a problem of defining capital.
Right.
Well, aren't you working with a value for defining capital at this point?
I guess you'd have to read...
Obviously not.
Defer to the capital improvement planning.
It's a weak definition in the capital improvement planning bylaws, as you...
Yeah.
Why don't you just name it, the kinds of things that you don't want?
Equipment and building.
Over a certain amount.
No.
Over $10,000.
I was gonna say, in the town of Deerfield, anything greater than $10,000 is capitalized, so to speak.
So to speak, but somebody decided to move the police cruiser out of capital.
Well, it's a yearly thing, so it's in the...
It's out of CIPC.
Right.
But the auditor may still call it capital.
Right.
Yeah.
And whether we need one every year or not is another story.
But whether we do or not, as far as I'm concerned, really should be, it's over a $10,000 expense, or it's over some number, that ought to go to capital for, capital improvement committee for review. But we can change that.
Well, then we can add, should we add, if we're gonna say services, activities, and non-capital expenses related to public health and safety, can we add a line item to say, and capital projects over $10,000 need to go to CIPC for the use?
Has to anyway.
There's none.
Not within revolving fund.
Well, there's a bylaw, there's the bylaw.
A new bylaw?
In here.
Yeah, we're gonna do it anyway.
That's what I'm asking.
A new bylaw that says it doesn't matter where the money's coming from.
Okay.
If it's over $10,000, CIPC needs to see it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
So that's
on the assumption that passes.
Yes.
Right.
That's correct.
So that item is after this one.
So if that doesn't, let's take care of this.
So what is the goal? Is the goal to limit a department head from just going out and buying because they have discretion over an account, a car, or something like that? I'm trying to help define it so we can, because, you know, at first I'm going, but why don't you just say add non-capital, only non-capital items? Where's the language?
Well, first of all, let me just throw out the fact that anything that we vote is a recommendation.
Right.
So it's not gonna change the article.
Right.
Somebody's gonna have to stand up and make that, and say that the finance committee recommends that we change the wording to...
If the committee...
How about excluding capital items and those over $10,000 and more? You don't want that to be spent from this account at all? That's what you're saying? You don't want to use this account for anything over $10,000? Is that what you're saying?
No, well, no, I made a motion for $50,000 is the spending limit.
No, but I mean in terms of capital.
Of capital, yeah.
You don't want to see any capital gains come out of this fund?
No. Then what's capital?
What if you get a whole lot of money?
That's the problem, what's capital?
Well, that's what I'm trying to define. I was saying anything over $10,000.
This is a one-year thing. This is not permanent.
But this is permanent. This part of it is permanent. The spending limit is not.
We use the term.
This is part of the bylaws.
You can change the use of the funds next year, too.
Right, but it's part, it takes a bylaw change. Yeah.
Does, so the spending limits get revoted every year?
Just the spending limits.
Just the spending limits.
The spending limits, the next motion.
The authority to spend funds does not?
No, it has to be changed.
So, but it can be changed with a.
Finance Committee, Select Board.
Bylaw change.
With a bylaw change.
And that was one of the reasons why I was wondering and asked whether all these should be separate articles, so you didn't have to take this whole thing.
Separate motions?
Separate motions.
Separate motions?
Yeah.
I don't know, DOR looked at it and said this is the way they see it, but.
Well, that's the easiest way, but I'm just saying if when it goes to change, at that point in change, if you want to change this one block, you have to bring the whole.
Article.
The whole article forward that includes all these blocks.
Yeah, but is that a big deal? So you bring the whole thing forward and say, here's what we want to change.
It's a pain. I just wonder if they would require you to do that. If we wanted to amend, could we amend whatever this thing is called by changing parks and recreation from authority to spend recreation department to authority to spend planning board? Why would we do that? We wouldn't, but would that be, could we do that a year from now without having to bring all of the other articles up and subject them to?
You said we're going to amend the bylaw to change this one thing?
Yeah. Well, that's my question. Could we do that?
Oh, yeah.
I don't see why not.
Yeah, you can.
Well, but that's not what I'm.
Well, it's not efficient. I mean, the whole point of this was, municipal modernization is so that the boards that work most closely with things like the finance and capital and select board, the departments that work with these monies and the financial people, can work with them and not have to have the town meeting people who are barely acquainted with the details of things.
But what I'm asking is whether you can go to town. Town meeting's got to approve it.
They approve the fund and the limit on the fund. That's it.
Do they approve the spending authority?
In this initial.
This first.
Well, you know, then, you know, then
can they then change.
Article to bylaw.
Well, you know,
can they change their mind? Could the town meeting change its mind 2 years from now and say, we don't want the highway department making the expenditures, we want the Board of Assessors to make the expenditures? Is that something
that
they could
do? Well, it appears what we've been saying, I believe, is it appears that you'd need the bylaw changed to do that.
Yeah.
But we need to, you know, we have to, I'm thinking, what is DOR thinking, really?
If they're going to take away
the constraint of town meeting, so we'll have to look into that.
Well, it does become very involved, because if you're putting this number in the bylaw, then what gives you the right every year to just change the number? Why wouldn't that open up the whole line? It's just a question, but I mean, it seems like.
Well, they were giving there's levels of financial authority or financial responsibility, and they're saying.
No, I wasn't looking for an answer. I'm just saying, my thinking a little bit. So.
Yeah.
So, but anyway, back to where we were. We hadn't progressed on that. So, you were saying, what was your wording? service activities, expenses related to providing public health.
Excluding.
Safety. Excluding.
Capital items. Those capital items of $10,000. Equipment, and what was the other word? Equipment and property? $10,000 or more? Is that what you said? What was the two words?
Equipment and what?
Well, equipment is property. Equipment and real estate? Equipment and real property?
Fixed assets?
That's a joke, I know. It's an insight.
No, it is, it's not really.
I think equipment and real estate, or, maybe we're beating it horse to death here.
I don't know, I wouldn't want the selectmen buying real estate without, or selling.
No, I mean, I think beating a horse when it comes to...
They need that anyway, so that's kind of not the issue, it's really, and I think this is your concern, that's why I ask, let's get it on the table.
No, we don't put it in here.
No, generally, it has nothing to do with the revolving, this is just for revolving funds. They need town meeting approval to, as we've got a few items, to purchase property or sell real estate, so that's separate from this.
Excluding what, capital equipment over $10,000, is that what you're saying, or?
Equipment and real estate of $10,000 or more.
Can we? I was gonna suggest that maybe we ought to meet next Monday, a half an hour before town meeting, or an hour before town meeting, and if we can get the wording of these things straightened out between now and then to vote, because it's just a, somebody's gonna have to stand up and make a recommendation to, which anyone can do, but you can say that the finance committee moves that we amend the article by blah, 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 blah.
Which is fine, but let's just get an agreement if on any of these that we may want to change at this point, so rather than open up the whole thing next Monday. I mean, you know, that's all I'm trying to do. You know, so...
But what I want to avoid is having town council say, that doesn't make any sense, you can't put that in that way.
Yeah, all right.
So...
Yeah, no, I'm just saying, you know, look at the ones that we might be interested in doing something with, and so...
Yeah, I mean, the first one, the $250,000 spending limit.
Could, if you really want to get a definition.
And that's an annual spending limit, isn't it?
Right.
Yeah.
Without any approval of anyone.
Could refer, if you want to get it defined, refer to the CIPC bylaw definition.
I was not involved.
As defined in 10-8.
I guess,
do it by reference, so I wouldn't have to do the whole thing. But, you have to explain that.
So I'd like to amend the motion to add on excluding capital equipment and real estate over $10,000.
I'll second the amendment.
Okay, so you want to explain...
So you're gonna make it as an amendment to the motion?
Yeah.
Yep. You want to, this is gonna be...
So I'll leave this.
No, he's making an amendment to our motion.
I see.
Not this one.
We'll vote on the amendment first.
So
the use of funds would read, service activities and expenses related to providing public health and safety services excluding capital equipment and real estate over $10,000.
And if the, obviously if the selectmen agree with that, then we don't make any motion.
Do you want to say $10,000 or more? Just to be clear.
Yeah.
Of $10,000 or more.
Which is generally the...
$10,000 or more.
The spending limit's 50,
even though I
oppose
it. I'm going to help you.
And the spending limit is 50, yeah.
Just because you have...
Is that still 50, right?
Yeah. That was my motion.
Got a motion on the table.
So that's the motion.
It's revised, yeah.
No, that's our motion.
That's our motion. We're gonna take the first motion.
And then...
Move on to the next one, or whatever.
See if we're agreement, we'll change it, and then it skips it. We'll fine tune it Monday.
Okay. Are there any others that we want to address at the same time?
We have to vote.
As far as the spending limit.
Recommend.
Well...
Do we have to vote on what Bruce is saying as a committee?
Well, if the committee is going to make a recommendation on town meeting floor, and we're going to say it's the committee that's making the recommendation...
I'm just saying, do we as a committee have to vote?
Then the committee has to vote.
No, do we have to vote now?
Not to.
You're saying as far as what we just did?
We
did one item.
Right.
In this block.
Right.
Are you saying you want to go down through each one?
No, I'm saying, do we need to vote at all? I don't know.
Are we going to vote?
To make a recommendation, you have to vote. Either you do it tonight, or you have another meeting and you do that. You make that vote then.
I'm not clear. No, I'm making myself clear.
Do you need to vote which exactly, John?
Normally, we as a committee, something comes up, we make a vote.
We just made a motion on at least one portion of this article.
Right, right.
Do you want to make, want to do it individually, or do you want to do it?
But we, at some point, we need to make a vote as a committee.
Yes, right, the recommendation.
But the question is, do we want to do public health and safety one vote?
That was my motion.
And then move on to the next?
Yeah, that's my motion.
Okay, then let's vote that.
That was my motion, so.
I think we set up if we just did one at a time.
That's what we're doing.
Yeah, that's what we're doing. I don't know how we bring that up on town meeting floor, because we're going to have to bring them up, since it's one motion. That's a problem. We've got this one article sitting here with, and it's obfuscating is what we're doing here at the moment. Not us, but by putting these all together and leaving them as a whole.
You know, I sort of wonder about it, because this is how it's done, and it's been done, and it's been done in other towns also as a block like that. I don't really understand why you couldn't break it out by each fund, but that's, I've never seen it done that way, so I'm just saying.
We as a committee can vote on each individual.
Right, that's right.
Have separate votes, and then when it comes to town meeting, we can go to the people in the town and say, here's what the committee decided. And go through each one. We don't have to tell them we voted each one separately as a committee.
Well, but it would be difficult to lay out, say, four or five motions to and ask those things to be voted in a block.
Right. If somebody was to agree on one of the items and not agree on the other item, that would be difficult.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. And you could. I mean, there's nothing that would stop.
If we recommend $50,000 and that one, most of the people would vote 50, but we reduced Parks and Rec to 50, and Park and Rec people said no.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're only recommending.
We recommend.
The Finance Committee recommended.
And so, 50. But can they, how are we going to vote the article?
Pro or con?
How are we going to vote yes or no on this entire article without individual votes?
Well, I think we're going to have to do individual votes on each one of these. Whatever changes we want to make, we have to make individual motions. And then the town will, you know, start throwing things at us if they don't like them. Or they'll vote them up or down, whatever way it goes.
Well, two steps have to happen. I mean,
so. And then once those are all done, take one vote for the whole thing.
Don't two steps have to happen? I mean, I'm a little naive here, but first off, you're going to make the recommendation to the town floor,
right?
And then if you want to follow through it, somebody has got to make a motion to change it.
Right. No, we're not going to make the recommendation. This is
the motion.
That's the recommendation
from the Finance Committee. We don't know what the recommendation is from the Select.
Well, we do know what they are. They're the ones that wrote this.
They passed.
This is their recommendation.
Yeah, they went through the whole warrant. You've got the certain budget items.
So. Yeah.
And this is just the exact wording that was in there last year. So I don't know where it came from or who put it together.
So, but there again, this is only a recommendation. So the motion is read as that, and then you're just reading off the recommendations. Nobody makes a motion to amend it.
You can. Anyone can make it.
That's what I'm asking.
Anyone can get up. One moderator can. Someone raise their hand. I'd like to amend. And poor Mr. Graves.
Let me ask this question then. So we take Article 4 to see if the town will vote to. So everybody in the town meeting is going to have this motion.
It's actually Article 5, by the way.
Okay, everybody at town meeting is going to have the motion.
Right.
So unlike some of the...
They won't have the commentary, but they'll have the motion.
And somebody's going to read the commentary? Is that why it's in red?
The comments...
No, the comments...
Our guide to the people at the table, you'll see it, okay. And the Select Board, we will see it, but... The town meeting will just see the warrant, the articles, and the motions.
At
the comments.
At the meeting, we'll have that.
Yeah. And then, so they will have this, so that if you then stand up and say the Finance Committee recommends that we change public health and safety, however you want to change that. And it needs to be written and given to the moderator.
So, I guess we're voting on this first one, going on to second one?
As far as I'm concerned, we can. I just want to make sure everybody's clear as to how this has to work. Okay, so would you do me a favor, reread the...
Okay, I make a motion for public health and safety under use of funds to read service activities and expenses related to providing public health and safety services excluding capital and real estate of $10,000 or more.
Capital equipment, I think.
I'm sorry, capital equipment and real estate of $10,000 or more. And also in the spending cap under fiscal years to reduce that from $250,000 to $50,000.
So that would probably be a separate motion.
Second motion.
That would be separate.
Separate, just because there are two separate motions. One of them is to adopt the bylaw, and then the second one is to spend, set the spending limit.
Okay, so there is...
Right, so I think you'd want to do that as two separate things. That's my thought.
Okay.
But we can make it one motion as a committee.
Yeah.
Well, no, because you're going to, because it won't be up for... The town meeting will not be considering the spending limits until after it votes.
After we adopt
yes.
the budget.
Oh, that's,
no, what I'm talking about is a committee. Here's what we as a committee decide.
I
change this and change that.
Okay, but see...
Let's vote it separately so that when whoever's going to make the motion on town meeting floor...
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So we have a motion. Is there a second?
There already is a second.
Yeah. Okay, is there any additional discussion? All of those in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
6-0-0.
Okay.
If I eliminate the first motion...
5-0-0.
I eliminate the first motion? Just eliminate it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I make a motion to reduce the spending limit. Do you want to stay?
We might as well stay with these, and we'll do them in the order in which we're going to take them.
Okay.
Okay.
Any other?
To
spend.
Oh, no, I thought we were going to do all these first.
Yes, yeah.
Oh, yeah,
you want to make changes. Okay. Do you want to make any additional changes?
Okay.
I have a concern about planning board.
Well, how about recycling? Let's just go right down.
We're down. Recycling?
Yeah.
I don't know how much money is it.
They've got $20,000 that they're spending.
Yeah.
That's not a whole lot to get.
What is it? What is it now?
It's the balance of that account. It's, I think, $21,000, $22,000. It's pretty specific as what we can spend the money on and what we can't. That's kind of controlled by Franklin County Solid Waste Management.
There again, that isn't a whole lot, but I mean, if you wanted to consider putting on excluding capital
one
again.
Assessment of
well,
four
it includes
quarters.
Capital.
But I'm thinking you could do a second one based on what the balance of the account is. I was going to tell Kevin that.
Would this allow us to purchase a new paper compactor?
Not without going to CIPC if it's over $10,000.
If the bylaw later on.
Probably not with that funding limit, just in terms of.
$100.
Yeah.
That's what I said, that's pretty limited.
Yeah.
So I don't have any problem with it.
Yeah, I don't have any problem.
Parks and Rec. This is what we have in place now. It isn't changing?
No, it hasn't changed in years.
Planning board, what's in place? Is this in place now, or is this changing?
Yeah, nope. This is the same as it's always been.
And I, you know, those expenses keep going up. And yes, some of it gets paid by the applicants, but we have a lot of activity going on and anticipated. And I encourage you not to reduce anything related to planning.
Well, Parks and Recreation. I'd like to put the capital exclusion in that one.
Which cap?
Okay. Parks and Recreation. Capital expend, capital items, activities and expenses related to providing recreational activities excluding equipment and real estate more than $10,000. I don't want them going out and buying a whole new ball field.
I don't even want spending $10,000 on something. But they pretty much, I haven't seen that, and I wouldn't even want to give them the idea that they could spend.
They could, right.
Well, they wanted to buy a school board. I think that's.
Yeah. What?
School board.
School board.
Sorry.
I understand them.
A school board?
A school board.
I don't think Sue would even consider something like that.
Well, no, but
no, I'm just saying.
Would you approve that if it came through?
What's that?
Would you approve it if it came through?
She wouldn't even do it unless she got permission from somebody.
Well, there again, you can't look at the individual.
This is
not for tomorrow's benefit. This is, you know, somewhere down the road.
Well, if you have this goal of, again, never mind. You have this goal of, you know, making sure that monies are not spent on a major item without multiple levels, you know, then add that language.
So was that a motion, Joe?
Yeah, if we're going to do it for public health and safety,
I think if I were you, I'd never approve something
and
like
I'd second
that
it.
Under this language.
I would not.
You know, this clearly is for.
So you want to add that same language to
Parks and Recreation?
Parks and Recreation.
Automobiles.
Right.
Well, it wouldn't make any sense to put it under the roadside mower, would it?
No.
Not anymore.
That would be kind of tough.
But one would hope that before they
But then where do they get the money? Wait a minute, I back up. Can we back up a second?
Yep.
Sure. Because that's the only money they have.
Right.
Is from this fund.
Well,
so
that's why I'm saying it wouldn't make any sense for us to add that condition to the roadside mowers.
No, to Parks and Recreation.
Well, it would to Parks and Rec. I mean, they're not.
Well, where do they go? Then where do they get the authority to spend $11,000 for a scoreboard? Where does it come from?
Where's what come from?
The money.
It comes out of the Parks and Rec?
Yeah.
No, but if we put that exclusion in there that they can't have a capital item,
then they couldn't. They couldn't.
So how do they get it?
They couldn't.
They can never get that scoreboard.
No, that's not.
No, they have to come through channel.
Different ways, different sources.
Through the channel.
They have to do a
warrant
appropriate, a warrant.
Right.
Exactly.
A year later. Which is fine. Which is fine. We don't want to putting. These are funds that are paid for by the people who are, you know, whether it's adults or children, whatever.
Participants
in programs. And
but, you know, you all do realize a lot of funds come from donations from the private, the nonprofits, as Deerfield has come to call them. And that's where a lot of this money comes from. And some major work is
done. In the
done.
Parks and Rec department?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We also have to remember there's a lot of volunteers involved, too, and they do serve a lot of people in the community. I think they do a pretty good job myself.
Mm-hmm. I guess I'm having second thoughts on my motion.
Yeah, on that particular one.
You want to withdraw it?
Well, it's been seconded, though.
You can withdraw.
You can withdraw it so long as the person is seconded.
I'll withdraw it.
Okay.
Sorry.
So at this point, the only thing that we've done is public health and safety. We've put a restriction on that, or we've recommended a restriction on that. Now, if you can talk the select board into putting that restriction on there, then we don't ever have to bring it up at town meeting.
Right.
School resource officer, well, planning board, is there anything that...
The only concern I have is that the use of the funds. Activities and expenses related to proposal and permit reviews. Well, those are all paid for by the applicant.
Yeah, those are actually in different funds. The two, we have two other funds that are used that are not 53E and a half, so they've never been on here. And they are, you know, they receive money in specifically for a peer review, and then whatever money is not spent on that peer review has to go back to them with interest.
Okay.
So this. So they're in and out.
So this money is for FERCOP only.
Well,
another experts they might employ.
Okay. I don't know. I just, all I know is that the money that goes in there are the
town council.
Like Sarah Campbell out of this money?
No.
What's that?
No, the consultant played.
But didn't they pay us and then we?
Yeah.
She worked for us.
Yeah, but not under this account.
No, that's under one of those other accounts.
That's what I'm saying. This is so specific.
This started out years ago, before, I think it was maybe only 2 years ago that they put in all the fees.
Right.
But this one started way before that.
Yeah.
And it never got changed. The wording never got changed
exactly
when they put
point.
In the fees.
What word?
Service activities and expenses related to provide.
About that.
Permit.
Oh, I'm sorry, wrong one.
Activity
and expense related to proposal and permit reuse. That was put in prior to when they started,
the peer reviews
and fees for all that, and the wording just never got changed.
So the only this account covers FERCOG. It did cover FERCOG when they reviewed the medical marijuana, because that was not part of their scope of services under the general contract. There are some reviews that they do that are not under the general contract.
Right.
That's the only place that I see who you could pay out of this fund. That's why it's the amount of money it is. The planning board has very little expense.
They have a lot of legal expenses, a lot of advertising expenses, and the FERCOG expenses are growing, both specific to reviewing things and just general technical assistance and bylaw reviews and things like that. So.
But that is that in FERCOG's contract with the town? We've already gone through that. Is that a line item?
I'm confused that we've got this other fund now.
Yeah.
There's two other funds that are specific peer review funds.
Right.
So money comes in, money goes out, it's all a wash.
And which boards are they for?
CONCOM and Planning Board.
So how do you distinguish between this fund and that other fund for Planning Board?
Those are specific. They receive the monies in specifically for a peer review. So then they do the peer review, we pay for it, and then the difference between what they gave us and what the peer review is goes back to them with interest.
And so these are just the fees, the application fees.
Mm-hmm.
So it wouldn't, okay.
So this is money all coming in,
right.
Very little going out. Only FERCOG.
Mm-hmm.
Or a town council, like when they had town council.
I could go pull up an expense report, but it'd take me a little bit to do that. I could do it.
No, I get you.
But I think...
Because they've only used... Last time we checked, a month or so ago, they had $83 expended out of...
Out of their appropriation.
Out of appropriation.
Well, I just processed a whole bunch of bills that were...
Out of appropriation?
Those came out of the revolving fund.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
And who are they for?
FERCOG.
That was for their annual contract.
So...
And they were not... They should have been paid a while ago.
Okay, so that it was not part of the annual contract, or was
one of them? One of them was part of the annual contract. The other one was a specific review for the Sugarloaf condominiums.
Okay.
So they came out of two different funds. One came the general contract came out of the planning board fund, and the other one came out of one of the peer review funds.
I guess
we have to pay for the Sugarloaf condominium.
We don't.
No, they paid it. They paid us.
We had the review done. No.
Well, there's two pieces to it.
FERCOG we paid because the planning board needed assistance.
We don't have a town planner.
Like they did with the town council.
Okay.
It's very...
Okay.
So that just highlights my point again, that they don't need that general account of $6,000. Because what are they spending?
Didn't we reduce it?
No, we did, but... If they're using all the, if they're using,
postage.
They brought it back.
What
they
say about
postage meetings,
copying supplies, any other expense?
Okay. It can't be used, and these are all related, expenses related to proposals and permit reviews.
Which are minimal at this point.
Right, well, I'm saying they're all related. You don't need, they don't need a budget line item, but they've already got one. So my point is, next year, we're gonna eliminate it if they don't spend any money out of it, which they don't need to. They have this the way it is. And I'll leave planning board just the way it is with limitations, without any limitations. Because this allows them to spend all the money that they could possibly.
Some of the way we're set up here for ease of purpose, I guess, is we absorb like everybody's departments, all these costs for, yes, paper, supplies. So the actual cost of each service area is not necessarily. I'm trying to do that more with the legal budget in particular and really see where we're spending our costs.
Would it warrant any thought of just not having a planning board revolving fund, increasing the planning board budget?
Budget line.
Yeah.
Allow this to disappear and go into general fund?
No, because they have
and raise their appropriate.
Then they wouldn't have a place to put their fees they charge for A&R lots or something.
Put it in revenue.
That would go to general fund.
It would go to general fund. If you eliminate this account, then the income would go into the general fund. And I think the hard thing about doing that is that business fluctuates. And I think that's probably why they had the revolving fund in the first place. Because one year might be much higher than another year, and to try to budget for that is tough.
Good point.
Well, yeah.
Until they had sufficient money in this account, in this revolving account. Once they had sufficient money in this revolving account, they haven't needed the other account. But that's fine. Yeah. The money's going to come back to us in free cash.
Well, that, I just don't that think money, yes, but this money.
This no. money is. It's caught never going to get used up, I don't think. It's caught in limbo. Unless we try.
Well, anyway.
Okay, I'm not going to change that.
Okay. Yeah, we're not going to solve it tonight.
Yeah. So where are we?
School resource.
Okay.
Any changes anyone wants to make to that other than me? If I knew how to freeze that $45,000, I would do it. But I don't know how to freeze that $45,000.
Me neither.
I will find out.
Well, consider what's the repercussions if we just specify wages only?
I just and doesn't.
As I was saying, so much
we've
of
already
I know
paid for their wages. This should be eliminated and set up to another revolving account where donations specifically for wages for the capital resource officer should be put. Frontier's money, Deerfield Academy, DA's money, and any other, if elementary school eventually puts money in, there should be a separate revolving fund just for wages, and that should be deducted from their budget.
Why do we need a revolving fund at all?
Because
we get a lot of donations.
It's donations.
They can still go, can't they go into general fund?
They won't. I would assume that some of the schools would not donate to us if it went into the general fund.
Yeah.
Okay.
It would get lost.
Okay. Where do they where do their donations go to now?
Right.
Okay.
What's that?
Where do their donations go to now?
Well, there's a general yearly donation that they make that goes into the general fund.
Okay.
And then they make some specific donations to various things. Mm-hmm.
I think the way to resolve it is another revolving account. This one is donations only, and the other one is resource officer wages and salaries.
But are you proposing that for this year? Or?
I don't think you can do it this year. Okay. Right now.
I would, you know, I think it's worth looking at.
I agree.
Roadside.
I think especially, I just don't know how you're going to account for the $15,000 that Frontier is budgeted to pay.
Well, hopefully they'll write us a check that says school resource officer. When they do, it goes into the school resource officer account.
We would have to bill them, I would think. They're not going to write us a check.
Nah, it comes out, it's part of their budget.
Yeah.
Is it in their budget?
It's in their budget.
I don't know.
It's in their budget, yeah.
It's in their budget.
I don't know.
We would have to bill them.
But we've already appropriated a full amount in the police department.
Right, so they'll have an access.
Now this becomes a slush fund per se.
Well, that's what I'm saying, unless you put it in their budget. The $15,000 goes into their budget. Then it becomes free cash at the end.
It's not doing me any good.
Okay, we do have this piece here. Somebody wants to make a motion on.
Okay, I'll make a motion, public health and safety. Do you want to, if there were other changes, do we want them as separate motions from the committee? Or do you want just one big? Do them all at once, Skip.
I'm not sure what you're.
Let's say for sake of conversation, we want to change parks and recreation to 25. So now public health and safety, I want to make a motion to be 50. Parks and recreation, I want to be 25. Say only for conversation. Do we want to make that one motion, or do we want to say, I make a motion for 50, we all approve it, and then we make another motion for 25?
Why don't we just go down through and just have a general discussion?
I would do separate, mostly because.
We did these as separate.
Well, if we're also standing on town meeting floor, and you say, I want to reduce public health and safety to 50,000, I want to reduce recycling to 10,000, and half the people agree with you on each one of these, but they don't agree with you on the other one, and it's like,
that's not a problem.
Okay. All right, can I make a motion to reduce public spending limit? Do you want to do it? Well, you're the one that did it.
Okay, make a motion to reduce public health and safety spending limit to $50,000.
I'll second it.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Anything else?
Anything else on that item or on
the, on the list?
On the list.
Yeah. Can the planning board. I wonder if they're going to spend $24,000 on it.
Yeah. All right. What else do we need to cover that we haven't? We've already covered most of these.
We covered. We passed on a few from our minutes. We didn't pull the minutes.
We didn't vote on longevity, did we? Or did we?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, we did.
We passed over 5, 9, and 18.
We didn't vote on.
But the numbers are different.
They're just up one. In this copy I gave you tonight. So 7 is 8, 8 is 9.
Okay, so 6, 10.
But we did vote on the classification compensation plan, didn't we?
Yes.
We did on OPEN too.
Yeah.
We did OPEN.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And we the 22,500 for the police department. So that was voted. So what's the next one that we
need?
I'd say we have 10 we passed over.
That's the one, let's see, two.
That's OPEB.
That's OPEB, okay.
11 is wastewater.
So number
8 was, okay.
Or are you talking about 11?
Which ones do we need to review tonight?
I thought you had gone through all of them last time.
The only one was 18.
Okay.
What's the new 18 or the old 18?
New 19.
The new 19.
The new 19. So it's on here as
19.
On here is 19.
Yeah.
Free cash?
I don't know.
No, wait a minute.
Well, do you want to vote on Smith Folk, or did you do that earlier?
We did that earlier.
Yeah.
To the $1.
Which one?
We must have done 18, which was 19. Well, 18, 17 we did, 18 we passed over, meaning we didn't need to vote.
Are you talking about the new 18 and the old 18?
Old 18 we voted on as 17. 17 we voted on, which is now 18. 18 we did, we passed over, which is now 19, which...
You need to talk about the content of the article.
Article 19, Highway Department Facilities and Recreation Department.
Right.
That's 20, that's 20 now, right?
That's 19.
Okay, so look, the one that's listed here as...
20.
You got 19.
Well, those are all off.
They're all changed.
These are, they, you add one to all of these.
I'm looking at what we, in the minutes. Last week was 18.
So refer to the content, that would be...
I know.
So that transfer free cash to 90,000?
So if last week it was 18, it's actually 17 then, in here.
So tonight, we did vote on Article, what's listed here is Article 17, but should be changed to Article 18.
That's correct.
And that was the $1. So what's listed here is Article 18, which should be Article 19. We did vote that last week.
The $90,000.
To $90,000.
So Article 19, which is Article 20, does anyone want to make...
That's not a moment.
Yeah, I mean, do we want to make any comments about that at all?
No.
No.
Okay.
Don't worry what you read in the newspaper.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
If there's nothing else...
Well, I... I do have a comment. I do have a comment.
Well, you're welcome to make the comment.
I was concerned with the compensation schedule. I've been concerned from day one. So what I did is I went through our budget sheets and took all the town employee salaries, union and non-union. I did not include Frontier or Franklin Tech. This year, total employee increase in salary was 6.83%. It went from 2,470,000 to 2,640,000. If you add the school in, the school was at 6.34% increase. We had total salaries in the community of $6,252,000 with the 6.54% increase. If you add the benefits in, we end up with a total benefit package increase of 10.93%, with total employees cost in just town employees out of our budget, $7,786,000. More than half of our budget is town employee salaries and benefits. That does not add Frontier's budget or Franklin Tech's budget. My concern is, if half of our budget is at, right now, the average was, I mean, the percentage increase this year was 7.39%. If we ended up at 7% next year, we would have to reduce all the non-salary employee and benefit, all the non-salary line items by 2.5 to 3% to come up with a 2.5% budget increase. So I think it's not sustainable. We've made this comment before, this compensation schedule at 5%, because what it does, it increases salaries, also increases benefits. Because they look back at retirement from the year prior, so next year won't be the 5%. This year was almost 10% increase. My concern is it's not sustainable with 5% comp schedule, without a merit inclusion to go from grade one, step one, to grade one, step two. You need a merit increase. It cannot be an automatic increase. Or we're gonna be out of business very soon. We're gonna be having budgets that are 6-7% increases. Because you're not gonna, even if we level fund the common needs, we're going to be at 7% increase.
I agree. I voted again.
I just want to make that statement. I think it's not sustainable. We can't keep up with the school. We're at 2.6 million town salaries. The school is at 3.6. It's not a big difference, but we're 53 full and part-time employees. I don't know how many is at the school. I'm not sure how many is at the school, but there's a lot.
So we have, what did you say the town's?
This year, $2.639 million.
2.6?
Yep. And the school was 3.6.
Elementary, not Frontier.
Elementary, right. Not Frontier, and not Franklin Tech. This is just town employees.
So
over 75% of them are union.
How many, over 75% of what are union?
Town employees.
The police. You're talking school and police? Police, just police?
Mm-hmm. School, police.
Right.
So
which we have nothing to do with.
How many town employees do we have?
We have 53 full and part-time.
Hi, Barb would have those numbers, but I'm guessing it's over 300 altogether.
Yeah, including?
Part-time police, I didn't count any part-time police. Just I counted I counted EMS. I have each one broke down.
There's quite 40 for EMS.
I didn't count part-time. Part-time.
Oh, okay. And then so just the 9.
Full-time, what the salary was, I actually included.
Then they'll all go union.
That's what I'm saying.
If we don't, if we vote against the wage classification, they're all voting union. So
no matter what, we're going to do damn for damn. That's my point. And we're on the road.
Because of the schools and the police. Because right.
And we need to have more input in both of those is the only way we're going to stabilize this budget. We can't have one representative from the four towns representing us at any school budget paper. We need a lawyer there, and we need at least three other people from the towns.
Mm-hmm. Well, the schools have a lawyer at
schools for them.
Well, when they negotiate with their employees.
Union.
Right, the union.
They have a union rep. Well, it may or may not be a lawyer.
The school administration has an attorney there as well.
Yeah, there's an attorney for the schools.
As we would in a contract negotiation. As we certainly should. As we have in the past. Not always.
But as Bruce explained, this is, and I think a few other people have been saying this for a while now, this is not sustainable. And I think when we looked over budgets, you know, schools were one where when you looked at the budgets and the line items and that, and as I tried to explain, 90-95% of that budget was salary related.
Well, 3.6 and 4.2.
Right.
And you just can't. It's a service organization. That's
right,
what government
exactly.
is about,
but,
providing
but,
services.
But at some point in time, as was said, we're going to hit the wall here, and this town is headed for a 2.5 override. Because, you know, at some point in time, taxpayers in this town aren't going to be able to swing it. They're not going to be able to swing the increases, especially the elderly that, you know, some of them can handle it. There's no question about it. But there's a lot of people that are on fixed incomes that are not going to be able to handle
exactly.
it. And it's going to hit the wall pretty soon.
Yep.
And, yeah, we're going to make it through this year. There's no question about it. But down the road, it's not going to be all that far down the road from what I've seen here anyways.
I don't think there's any discussion about that. I think we all know that.
Well, no, I just want to make it
public. You know, unfortunately, you have such a small area
mm-hmm.
to work with.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
You know, it's inevitable. Now, what the answer is, you know, if any one of us had it, I mean, you know,
right. It'd be great.
But you're right. But it's a multitude of things.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
you've got 800 residents that are on town sewer. Mm-hmm. That's not even including what's going on. Look at what the South Deerfield Water did this year. Look mm-hmm. at what the South Deerfield Fire did this year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not...
His rates went up.
Yeah.
Twice.
You pay double.
Fire doubled.
It's everybody, and it's none of it's sustainable.
It's everybody.
Let's face it, Proposition 2.5 was designed to fail to begin with. Okay? It never was a realistic number.
Well, somehow or other,
we managed to way over
and a half for 30.
We have a $10 million gap right now.
37 years, and we've never voted a Prop 2.5 over.
Right. Okay. But it's going to come to an end. Okay, you can't.
Your tax rates have gone up, and we have sidestepped the 2.5.
We have not sidestepped. We've debt exclusion. That's part of 2.5.
Right. No, I understand that, and it's been a big help, and I understand why we do it. But at the same time, you take a look at your tax bills, and you listen to what people are saying in town, and there's a lot of people that aren't happy with their tax bills.
But you know what?
But I know they can't do much.
Right.
The problem is, it still boils down to voter apathy. Okay, if these people don't show up, if all they're going to do is complain down to juries and complain up there and complain down there, mm-hmm. but not show up on a town meeting when it's okay, we have a $15 million budget here this year.
I agree. 100% I agree with you.
You know, I'm sorry.
Shame
on us.
It is. Because we don't have much to say about the Frontier budget, but they have a department head that's in charge of all the janitors and maintenance. He's paid $90,000 a year.
But there again, at town meeting, every time
nobody knows that.
Every time we've tried to quell the school budget, what's happened?
When I went through looking at their salaries.
Well, it's incredible. Somebody needs to run for the school committee.
Yeah. No. Their salaries are outrageous. We were trying to match
and
those.
We're not going to solve them tonight.
No.
I just want to bring it up that I felt
point well taken.
Well, I think what we should be talking about, and we are in other places in the town government about, okay, problem, what's a solution? It's not, you know, you got to look for multiple solutions, and I think with this board, they are. And I've been in and around this town off and on for the last 4 years, and I see the amount of business development, the DEDIC's back running. We've got a board that's pro-business and looking for opportunities to grow, and we get approached pretty regularly. And we're positioned well. There were state agencies that are cutting back in Northampton and Greenfield, and they're looking at Deerfield, and I just think the opportunities are more here than many other communities.
I mean, that's a good thing, but nobody knows that. It's the first time I've heard.
Oh, well, hello, folks.
I'm just saying.
So,
I mean, nobody knows that.
Well, I think if people look around, they can see that. I mean, there are all kinds of things we can talk about that people don't want to talk about in terms of looking for revenue sources. But we'll see.
I mean, $1 million.
We need to talk about it, the possibilities as well as the challenges, and that's really what I hope we do.
Take 7% of our budget and use 7% of our budget free cash.
Yeah.
How long is that sustainable?
That's remarkable, actually, when you look at other communities.
Kudos to you for doing that.
I'm saying we use $900,000 a balance budget.
Of free cash?
Yeah.
Well, I was talking about the amount you actually
Used $900,000 to balance the budget for the past four
years. I think it's wrong.
So it's nothing new.
I don't agree with it.
No.
What do you want to say?
You've got?
Yes.
What would you use?
Stabilization.
Well, that's what it is.
No, it isn't. It's reduced the tax rate low.
We're stabilizing the tax
rate. Just what they did to the sewer department.
Mm-hmm.
They kept the tax rate low for 25 years. Now they can't afford to build a new sewer treatment plant.
And that's why you're going to see more and more debt.
And that's exactly what's going to happen. If we keep using free cash to balance a budget and not putting it away, we're going to be in the same boat that the sewage commission is.
Tim Bruce is right, and that's why you take a look at that capital stabilization fund. First time in how long that we're recommending $200,000.
Before.
And that's only a drop in the bucket.
Right, that's a drop in the bucket.
Unfortunately.
I mean, it's been years and years and years where nothing's gone into that.
Hopefully, there will be a national infrastructure program. And if it was like the last one, you have to be shovel-ready. So the more we can get to know what we need to do and be ready to go, I would say.
I had five shovel-ready projects and I turned them all down. Shovel-ready, bid-ready.
Well, they were.
Not the ones that got awarded were not bid-ready.
Well, we gotta make friends as well.
The, before, you know, I agree.
I know many that were funded in Hampshire.
$1.5 million in free cash. But it's the method that we've used for budgeting that does that. It's not that someplace along the way, this $1 million, $1.5 million in free cash just remarkably shows up every year.
I think it's not the budget that gives us the free cash. It's additional revenue.
It's not the additional revenue, it's the fact that we budget local receipts in particular, so
right.
there's such a gap in there.
Right.
That I agree there, but our budgets are not conservative. Right.
And some people with the free cash are aware what it's being used for, but other people see that free cash and say, why not go for it? The town's got the money, and they misunderstand what that free cash is there for.
Well, that's, you know, part of the argument for the last 5 or 6 years that we not spend money, particularly on capital items, any place other than the annual town meeting.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with that. Happens when we spend $750,000 at a special town meeting for capital
which
items.
We should not be doing.
So and we pretty much that isn't happening.
I saw you looking at the clock.
Yeah, I'm ready.
We're 2 hours and 15 minutes.
Did we cover the church?
No. Please do.
No.
As a committee?
No.
I don't think so.
It has to be sewer users.
I got a problem with it.
Okay, yeah, I didn't.
They can enter into any agreement related to the receipt of the gift.
Thank you, Wendy.
As they determine the best interest of the town. So they
can
enter into an agreement to spend $400,000.
No, it's a new 22.
It's a gift. It's a gift.
No, it's authorizing the selectmen to enter into any agreement.
Yeah, but here's the motion to accept the gift.
Read on. And to enter into any agreement related to the receipt of the gift.
Right, to the receipt of the gift.
Yeah, so to receive the gift, we need to spend $300,000 to fix the floors.
Well, when you take on property, that they're not demanding, there's not going to be a demand that we do something.
We're
mostly that we don't do something to the building.
We're giving them permission to do it.
We're giving the selectmen permission to
negotiate.
To spend anything.
Pardon?
We're not giving the selectmen.
We're giving them permission to enter an agreement to spend.
No, we're not. Where are they going to get the money from?
Have to come to us or to you to get any money.
Or the
town. And by then, once again, they've entered into a contract, committed the town.
To fund a building that either you take it down or you go to improve it.
Whatever. But they're committing the town to something that really hasn't been approved. That's specifically the thing.
I
have a problem with that.
I agree with you that we're being committed to a building that's going to need some repairs. If we're going to use it as for municipal use.
And they can enter an agreement for those repairs.
No.
No, I don't see that.
It's just an agreement to take the building.
Related to receipt of the gift.
Well, okay.
That would be like saying we could authorize the selectmen to take the building by eminent domain for no more than $1.
Basically limited to not and turning around.
Would do the same thing.
Yeah.
But it doesn't give them any permission to spend money.
Yes.
Even if they take it by eminent domain.
Not that you're going to do that, right?
I'm not comfortable with the way this thing is going.
There are some things about it that I'm not comfortable with either, but the money issue is certainly not one of them. I don't worry about
that. I think after we get it, I think that's when we're going to see the issues.
Mm-hmm. But then if we get it, if we have it, it's too late. We got it. So now we've got a white elephant.
Maybe. Now we have.
Maybe, I know you remember the church.
No, but
the white church.
The white
steeple. And it's really big.
The white elephant.
Well, that same
it's
question.
The one that's sitting right beside it.
Same question was asked last night at the Finance Committee and the Select Board in Waitley. We understand that there's an article for the town to accept the church. What is it going to cost us? We're part of the senior center. So we're moving the senior center there, right? Yeah. Well, how much is it going to cost us to move the senior center there?
For the town of Waitley?
Yeah. 25%. My town. They don't know the number, but they know the percentage. Mm-hmm. 25% of some number they're going to be subject to if the senior center moves there.
But does that include the building? Bring the building up to snuff?
Yeah.
Does it? Or is it just operations?
Well, to see the agreement.
Their concern is that they're going to own 25% of improving to make that building into a senior center than operating.
Would they like what it was going to cost to pay 25% of what it's going to cost to...
I was just going to say that.
I'm just saying, brought up.
Unfortunately, you got, a bad building and a terrible building.
I know.
And it's like...
really, do we need a vote?
It is a huge difference between the bad and the terrible.
Yes, there is.
Isn't it like they're kind of like...
Skip, are we going to try to meet
prior? I would like to have a meeting prior to, just so that if there's something that comes up.
Yes.
Now, town meeting is at 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
So if we met here at 6 o'clock...
So meet here at 6 o'clock.
We met here at 6 o'clock.
Next Monday before the annual town meeting.
And I will be too.
Or what?
We're going to
meet
here? I've got to get the computer going. And
yeah, we got a lot to do over at the school, so we won't be.
What's the date?
It's on the
24th.
I can always forget. I can't.
I mean, could
6 p.m. here?
You just get it may be that we adjourn to the town meeting. But then if there's something that we need to do.
If there is such a thing.
You've got the hour to do it. Is that okay with everybody else this year?
Question. Yep. Unless we can meet at the school. Is there a room we could use at the school?
I could check and find out.
Just a thought.
Probably, yeah. I don't know if there is or not.
I don't know. Just a thought.
Okay. The green
room. We'll meet here.
If there is, just right.
The media.
Send an email if that should change.
Yeah. Pat will be in tomorrow if you send your posting.
Okay. Do you have a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second. It's moved. It's second. All those in favor?
Yes.
Aye.